Cosi again, South Yara again, another episode of Cooking with Chef Dona here in our beautiful courtyard, Cosi Bar Ristorante 68 Turak Road. Today, a very, very classic Cotoletta alla Milanese. So we have the hero of the dish, which is a beautiful cotoletta of veal, a mix of breadcrumb, parmesan, some herbs, no salt, and a couple of eggs just beaten up. Some salt, some fresh pepper. For the cooking, a steel pan over medium heat with some clarified butter on it. Let's get started. So what you wanna do, you wanna trim any excess of your veal cutlet or fat or sinews, silver skin, nice and clean, polish the bone, and then what you wanna do, just lightly bash it. Now, there are two different schools of doing this one. There's someone that likes, like, smashed it almost like paper thin, and some others, like me, that just like it bashed enough. So nice and thick. And that's it, that's what you are going to get at the end of nice and thin, as our customer loves. Then what I do is egg, bread, so you want to cover it. So what we use actually for us is a gluten-free bread, which is not, definitely not a classic in Italy, let me tell you, but it goes well in our beautiful South Yara. And then double dip, so we get nice crust, let drip the excess, and again into the bread. You want to apply some pressure with your hands, not too much. But you want to make sure that also the sides are coated and most of the surface is breaded. You can do this step in advance if you want. I recommend to just crumb and fry as you go to achieve maximum crispiness of the crust, because what happened is that the bread tends to start getting wet after a few minutes. All right, so our ghee is in temperature now. As you can see, drop it very, very carefully and let it color. Because it's so thin, obviously cooks within minutes. And normally, when both sides are nice and golden, it's ready. You don't want to overcook it. It's a precious piece of meat. You don't want to kill it. You don't want to lose all the juices. What we're going to serve our cotoletta with is a bit of salad. And for our salad, we want to use some rocket, shred parmesan, and just some orange segments in there. A bit of olive oil, some salt, and a tiny bit of lemon juice. It's now time to flip. You also want to have some paper ready to go, just to mop the excess of that clarified butter. And then some salt and pepper, just for seasoning, just at the end. Obviously, cotoletta alla Milanese is something that comes from the Milan region, north of Italy. It's a very classic. There are different ways of doing it. If you actually split your chop in a half, so like a butterfly cut, and your bone is right in the middle, that's what we call the orecchio di elefante, the elephant ears. All right, our cotoletta is now ready. Let's drip the excess. As you can see, the color is a beautiful golden on our paper. Another two or three on top. Apply very gentle pressure. You don't want to squeeze it, you just want to absorb the extra oil around it. Don't wait too long. You want to enjoy this one nice and hot on the plate with just a bit of salad next to it. To cut through the richness and the fattiness, a wedge of lemon, some salt, and that's it. Your cotoletta alla Milanese is ready. Cosi Bar Ristorante, Saltiara. Ciao, a presto.